a couple more minutes. Thumbs up? Okay, go ahead. I added a couple other things if you're done that I pulled up. I just added a couple other categories that I went back and looked at some samples from last year. So I'm on, it's page one where it starts numbering things. I just added some other things you could take notes on in that. When you're done, if you want to take a break and get a donut or go to the bathroom at this time, you can do that, okay? We'll just take our break a little bit earlier. I'm going to hand you something to do something with in a little bit. Finish on everybody, finish. So make sure you leave quietly.
did he send you this?
Because I don't know.
I asked him too. I sent him a copy email I sent you.
Who?
Pardon.
Oh, okay.
And we're thinking, because the time writing is Wednesday. He's, for some reason, he's allowing Grace to skip 75% of main camp, but we can't.
And there's other people that are doing it also.
Yeah, but he will not let us.
So you two are stars, so when I see you, you're gonna be like the stars?
No. I won't even be marching the halftime show.
Okay, starting with the show.
That's right. So I don't know, if that wasn't the agreement, and I wasn't all of the agreement, but Mr. Warren, I'm sure, football, I'm sure, well, did you make it to football this morning from 6 to 8? You did, okay, because that was probably better than having it in the afternoon or not.
We've had
But is it better? Is 6 to 8 better than the 3 to 5 for you?
Yeah.
Okay, are you ready? Okay, so will you do, okay, take a minute though and look at the new, I added some more to the list if you haven't looked at that. Those were just things I thought of. I just cut and pasted it from somebody else's concept from last year. They had just added some different things. So do you think you'll do all of these every single time?
No.
I think it'd be impossible. Do you think there'll be some times where you'll do some for fiction and some for informational text? Mm-hmm. Do you think there might be some that you would do for both? Maybe, I don't know. I don't know because some of it's definitely fiction. So what I want to make sure is that you understand the difference between fiction, where would you do fiction, and where would you do informational text? So just for a minute, look at the numbers, and I think there's one through, I don't know how many I put on there now. I put a little chart on there, I'm getting all fancy, I have a whole bunch of stuff. One through, what'd you say? I'll get rid of the bold. 27, okay. One through 27. So maybe figure out which ones you would do for fiction and which ones you would do for informational text. Just take a look, go down, and in your brain go, fiction, informational text. I don't know. I need to ask. Fiction, information. So do that for a minute. All right, number one, just let's go through it. Number one, will you do that for fiction, informational text, or both?
Both.
Number two? Both. Number three? Both. And you don't know that author yet because you have it in your packet to read. So it's like, the title is Good Readers and Good Writers. So you'll be reading an article that we'll practice this with in just a few minutes, okay? That's why I put that on there for us to reference. It's in your packet of stuff that you have on your desk, okay? Number four. Informational text, fiction, or both? It says story, so you'll think fiction, but I bet you're going to be needing to make connections with other texts and other academic disciplines, because this is what becomes really cool in this class. For a while, you'll be like, we're reading all this stuff. And then there will be one day, And it's usually about week three, it just all comes together. And you'll go, oh my gosh, I read that that second day of class. I read that, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And you'll keep doing that throughout the rest of the class. If you're not doing that, then you're not getting out of the readings what you need to get out of the readings, okay? It's supposed to be all these puzzles and they come together. And that's what will happen. And until they all come together, that's when your eyes are wide open and your mind's all jumbled and you're like, what is going on? But they will eventually all come together. And it'll be easier if you take notes. Okay, keep going. Number five, what do you think? Fiction, probably. The ending, how many times? The rhetorical devices. Both. You'll have it in informational text and you'll have it in fiction. Relationships, sentence passages, chapters to whole, sections to whatever. What do you think? Both. Functions of the passages that do not carry plot functions. Where do you think that'll be? Fiction. Soapstone, smell, diddles. What are those? Informational text. Make a claim about a passage. Support it with details. Both. Probably mostly informational text. What is the speaker's mindset in a passage? They think? I hear. Probably informational mostly, but probably both because in the story you'll probably have a speaker, especially poetry, which we saw the, remember Wide Open Spaces when we were doing that with that song. What's the function of a chapter to a whole or a section to a whole? You said informational text and fiction both. You already said that one up above. And then activity for integrated citations, because one of the concepts that we have to work on for the synthesis, the free response question on the open response questions for the timed writings, is integrating sources. So this will, you'll choose a quote. It doesn't have to be from fiction. It can be from informational text, just something that you like how someone wrote it. You'll say what it means, you'll put down the page number or the paragraph, and then you'll have to think about the what is the purpose or the function of it. That what is analysis. So we're working on rhetorical analysis, rhetorical devices, we're analyzing text, we're analyzing literature. So that last column is the most important for anything that you'll do. Details and passages, explain their function, both, I would assume for you. Then I'll unbold these, but you have tone shifts. What do you think that will be? Fiction. And I will guarantee you, you'll have it in informational text because remember those tone words on this packet, the all you need to know packet, there is that tone chart that you're supposed to know those words. So that will be informational text also. Style will be informational text and fiction. Theme is only in fiction. There's only a theme in fiction. Setting, probably both, because you have speaker occasion and all that, so both. Writer's intention will be both. Conflict, it just depends on what type of informational text, but definitely in fiction. And definitely man versus self is always in fiction, those types of conflicts. Point of view and shifts. That will definitely be both. Mood shifts, both. Characterization, mostly fiction. Personal connections, you should try to do for everything, which is up above, so I can get rid of a couple of the duplicates. And then your response, your reaction as you read, what are you thinking? That's the curate, synthesize, and reflect. And then every title has a significance. The informational text titles have a significance. The fiction titles have a significance. And then I put literary technique of your choice. I could put rhetorical device of your choice too. It just depends. Literary technique is mostly in fiction, but if it's a speech, there will probably be some literary techniques that they use. And then also some rhetorical devices. What's the difference? They're kind of intertwined, so that I could just put a slash there. As long as you know what the term is, you won't need to know, is that a literary device or is that a rhetorical device? Because it's just a list of techniques that writers use, and that's what you have to start thinking of. Okay, so as you took notes on this, talk to me about some things that you wrote down. So look at your notes on the right-hand side, and I'm just going to go around the room, and I'm going to have you tell me one thing that you wrote down. Ready? Can't repeat it.
You start with me.
I'm gonna start up here.
Oh.
Go, one thing you wrote down.
Journal is to make it more personal and enjoyable.
Okay.
In the journal, you're not supposed to use phrases, you're supposed to write full sentences because that draws out your full thought.
Yeah.
What? What the stuff? I'm taking notes and not writing full sentences? She's gonna look for capitalization and punctuation? Yeah. Because I guarantee you that's why a couple of my people who got twos on their free response, not because of their critical thinking, but because they're so used to texting and they're so used to writing a U and an R instead of U and R, they missed the littles. We can't miss the littles. All right, go ahead. I'll give you questions. I'll give you a little guidelines. Like, hey, you're supposed to be doing this. These are always your questions up here. These are always. I'm going to pick and choose from these. So it's not like you're going to get new questions. I'm not going to say, what did this character do and what did that character do? Because you're done with those types of questions. I'm going to say, choose a main character and trace their character development throughout the book. Something like that. I'm not going to, like, make you answer a specific question about a specific character. Okay, so that's what she's talking about. I'll give you the questions ahead of time. It's not a surprise ever. Go ahead.
Eventually, we'll be building off each other's perceptions instead of trying to find out who's right and who's wrong.
Yeah. And that's when people get really mad at each other. Because you want to be right. You're used to being smarties and you're used to being right. And you're used to, like, if I speak louder, then I win. And that's not what it is. It's critical thinking. It's like, oh, there will be moments that you'll look at somebody and go, oh my. And I will tell you, probably the person who exhibited the most, and people finally got it, Ryan Sackville. I don't know if you know him, but Ryan would never hardly talk. He really wasn't a big talker. But when he spoke, and he didn't speak very often, when he spoke, it was mesmerizing. His brain is crazy great, and he got it. He got AP in week 2. Everybody else was week 4, week 5. He got it. And so I finally started saying, listen to what Ryan has to say. Because they would poo-poo him. Because he doesn't speak a lot. And he's not, I don't think he speaks a lot. Maybe you're like, no, he speaks all the time. He doesn't speak a lot. He's not real outgoing. He's kind of to himself. He's a cool kid. If you don't know him, get to know him. He's going to do great things in the world, okay? But I think they poo-pooed him all the time. Because he wasn't loud, he didn't shout, he didn't scream, he didn't try to push his way in through conversations. He'd speak if he had a chance, but all of this cool stuff going on in his head. And that's when people started going, oh my gosh, I like what he said. That was really cool. Say that again. And he'd be like, I don't know, I just said it. Like, just said it. Like, I don't remember what I said, I just said it. And everybody would be like, but remember what you said. And so as soon as he started talking, people would then be going like this. You know, like typing stuff down because he got it. And when someone gets it, you can't rely on them because they still got to get it on their own and you eventually have to get it. But you got to think about other people, what they have to say. And those people, and I have found the last 2 years, the people who don't speak often are usually the people who get it first because it's how they're reflective. They spent their whole life just being reflective and not being outwardly talking. And it's really weird. Because I'm an outward talker. I want to be, oh, can I get it? Can I get it? Like, I get it. I get that. And when I see those people, I'm like, hmm. And that's why I'll say to you, listen. I want to listen to this person. Because first a chance, listen. Because I bet there will be somebody in here that you'll be like, what? Okay, over here. What is, something new.
This method of taking notes might be frustrating at first, but it should actually heighten your enjoyment.
It will, and you will not have to reread. Because the idea is you're supposed to read and reread, and in college, your professor will say that a zillion trillion times, and you'll be like, I don't have time to read the first time. So if you read the first time critically, and you pause and reflect and do all that you're supposed to do, no professor's going to teach you to do this. They're going to expect you to just take notes on your own. They're going to care less if you take notes. They're not going to check your notes. You're not going to get points for notes. You're not going to talk to them one-on-one. You're going to have to do this all on your own.
So you'll learn how to do it and you'll be successful and your grades will show it. Those three tests that you take, you only usually take a couple tests in college, that's it for your whole grade. And it's all about, did you read what you're supposed to read and listen to your professor and put it all together? All right, next.
You have to read them out loud to make sure like they're quality thoughts.
Yeah. Is that scary? They're going to have to read, you know, when you say something like personal connections, what if a personal connection is super private? Well, no one's going to make you share a personal connection when we talk. You get to choose what you want to share. But eventually, if people aren't sharing personal connections, I'm going to have to do something to get you to pull those personal connections. So the easiest thing to do for personal connections is something that you've read before in another class, or something that we've read, or something you've seen or watched, or conversation that you've heard that's factual, not gossip in the hallway or something like that. This is not about like, I want to tell you a story of when I broke up and blah, blah, blah. That's not the type of personal connections, even though there may be some. It's okay to mention it. We'll be fine with it. But dig deeper for personal connections than just the surface. And I'll show you how to do that. Go ahead.
No text is meant to be read at like one pace. You're supposed to stop sometimes and reflect.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's where... It's always funny because people, you usually have one speed and one inside voice, you know, when you're reading. And when my kids were little, every book I read to them, I did characters. So it took forever for us to read books because I would change the character's voice. And they told me just over the weekend, because Chelsea and Claire leave for college this week, and then we were at church and then we went out to dinner and all that good stuff yesterday, and they're like, we were just thinking about like when we used to sit and read, like Judy B. Jones, and you had all those different characters. And Chelsea's like, when I read a book, I still do characters. She's like, it's so crazy, I still do it. And she's like, when I'm reading my college textbooks, I read them in a totally different voice. Like I try to just be like as plain as I possibly can with no inflection. And she's like, then when I read fiction, I'm always like doing different characters. And she goes, remember how we used to get mad at you when in the middle you would like forget which character you're doing and you'd switch your voice back? We'd be like, that's not the character. And I'm like, yes, I get it. And I'm like, so they get their inside voice. Which if you haven't had people teach you your inside reading voice, that you can slow it down, you can go faster, you can go slower. Miss Bennett can speed read. She'll come over and teach you a little mini lesson on how to speed read and when speed reading is appropriate. But she's had like 20 some years of speed reading, you know, like she knows how to do it. I always say if I take a test, I want Miss Bennett's brain. If I'm going to take a standardized test, I want her brain and just plop it into mine because I can't even imagine what she can do. She's this crazy, phenomenal smarty. But she slows her voice down. She slows her indoor reading voice down. And I know you're saying, but hold on, it's timed. This is a timed reading. But we will read so much that when we get to the timed reading for the multiple choice section of the test, you'll be so skilled at it because you'll know what to write down. You'll be training your brain to think about what is important. What do I write down? What are they? You're going to be able to predict the questions they're going to ask you because you're going to be so familiar with all of this if you do the journals correctly. Okay? Next.
If you make a claim, have something to back it up with.
Tech support always, always in here. You can't just say, well, I think blah, blah. You have to say, according to passage whatever and wherever, whatever page. Next.
I said that you're going to share your ideas with classmates, and it wasn't just me.
Okay, I'll let you fly by on that one. Go ahead.
Since we're sharing our notes with the entire class, it could almost become, or it seemed to become, collective notes.
Mm-hmm. I would definitely think you'd probably want, I never said put a person's name next to it. They last year said it helped a lot when I put so-and-so said this or so-and-so said that. So they put people's initials or nicknames or whatever. I mean, just be careful when you use nicknames. But they would write down who said what. And it was like, when you said blank, blank, and I was always impressed. And they had to talk about that on Twitter, and I wasn't involved in their AP Twitter conversations. Even though I saw them come across, I didn't pay much attention to them. But that's when they would figure out some things. How are we going to make class better? And they would come to a conclusion until like the next day they'd come in with some new strategy they were going to use. Okay, next.
At the end of first, second, and third quarter, we have a conference that sort of displays our growth.
Yes. I will tell you, you are going to be so proud of yourself. It's going to be one of those days that you're like, wow, I am like so smart. Like, just look at my brain. And you think you're smart now, I guarantee you at the end, they thought they were so smart, and even the people who did not pass the test, okay? It's tough when you don't pass the AP test. Most of the people who did pass the AP test still got A's in the class. And they grew. And they'll say, we were so smart. Like, I can't believe the conversation we're saying. And Brittany O'Brien said it a zillion times, and she does not speak. She's another one that does not speak, that when she did, you'd want to listen to her. Because she had crazy great thoughts. And she would say something, and people were like, whoa. And at the very last day, she said, oh my gosh. Like, I AP everything all the time. Adam Barber AP'd his youth sermon at church. He was doing some speaking at church, and he AP'd it. And he sent me a note after church. I AP'd the sermon today, and this is what I came up with. And I was like, whoa, you're doing that at church. Your mind doesn't shut off. Once you critically think, and you learn how to critically think even more than you already do, your mind's not going to shut off from it. You can't just turn it off, and you're going to want to. You just can't. Okay, in the back. I don't care who goes.
Who, me. Okay. The journal gets, so the journal is worth a writing assignment grade, and you get graded on how well the conference goes.
So it's like a writing paper, and it's everything you've done for the whole term. It takes a while for me to get through them. What is everybody else doing? You have other activities that you do while the other class is working. It'll just be a flip-flop, and I'll go through them. And we'll have a little check sheet, and I'll go through, and I'll tell you immediately. You'll know immediately what your grade is as soon as you're done. Okay? It's not hidden. It's not surprise. And people usually score really well. You just do what you're supposed to do. It helps in every other little crease and crevice of the class if you do these correctly. Now, did I have people skip to get them done? Heck yes. Yeah. They called in sick and skipped. Said they were sick because the journal was due that day and their conference was that day and they didn't have it done. Did they get a score for it? No. I didn't give them a score. It didn't hurt them. It didn't help them. I'm not doing that again this year. I'm not doing that. I did that because I didn't want all of the repercussions that would come with my decision because it should have been a zero. Because in the syllabus, it says, even if you're absent, things are due. Doesn't matter if you're absent. Not in college. Doesn't matter at all. Things are due when things are due. Okay, but I'm really sick. Well, nothing should be done the night before. You should have enough time throughout that you should have just turned something in. Okay? So did people think they could get by with it? Yeah, did some people show up and try to get by with it? You can tell because your mind changes and your reflection changes every time you look at a piece of literature. Even if you look at, like, every time I read To Kill a Mockingbird, I catch something new. It's my 26th year of reading To Kill a Mockingbird. I still see something new and I still read it from cover to cover. Everything I give you, I've read all of these packets, folks. I still read them. I read them again. I catch something new every single time. So if you do it all in one night, your mind frame's going to be in one night. I'm going to tell. Your writing's all the same, everything. If you try to act like I didn't, it's a game and it's exhausting to play. And somebody will figure it out and it's just going to hurt you. It doesn't hurt me. I don't need to pass the AP test. You do. Okay.
The left side of the journal is only for when the discussion of the
yes, so as soon, two more people, you're going to be writing some stuff down on the left-hand side. And two more people. Okay, go ahead.
Always come to class with key points ready to start the discussion.
Yes, because some days I'll say, and tomorrow will be the first day, I'm going to say we're going to start with, we're going to get started on these. And you should have read them, the close reading stuff. But now you're going to read them a little bit more critically. With the journal, and maybe you did it. Maybe you already did. And maybe you already have notes, you just have to cut and paste them and put them wherever. But we're going to have a little mini discussion, our first little kind of Socratic seminar on the articles. So we're going to number them so we can source them, say this is the first source, second source, third source, so we have numbers. Because that's how AP is, you have to give it a number. Okay, so good. Next, last.
And the left side of the journal, it's where you reflect everything you did and what you can do better next time.
Okay. So the better part of it. I'll let her add that to hers. But the better, like what you can do better the next time. What can you do differently? How can you cut it down? Because, folks, I'm not asking to write write a page. I'm not asking you to write two pages. I'm asking you to be reflective as you're looking at it. Pay attention to all of these little types of notes. I do not care, again, how you organize it. I don't care if you organize it by date, like this is one day, or if you say, these are the critical reading, this is the critical reading section, because all of these are about critical reading and close reading. And then your EAA chapters, organize those a different way. And then class, I don't care how you organize it, as long as when I read it, I can see it. Last year, I tried to force everybody to organize it the same way, which was an absolute nightmare, because it was just an unending battle. And everybody thinks differently. So it's just better if I say, you organize it how you need to, but here are the guidelines that you have to follow, okay? So now, on the left-hand side, let's practice. Let's put some reflection. What are some things that you could reflect that either somebody said, I said, or get it now, or still don't get it? Reflect on the left-hand side. That's what you're supposed to do now. Go ahead and do that. Are you guys leaving?
See if we can.
Well, no, I mean, you have to do it. I don't want you to get in trouble there. When you're done, pull out the papers that were on your desk, the articles for close read, and we're going to number them.
Vladimir Nabokov.
That's the author's name. Be our first one. Good readers and good writers. This is a staple piece. If you know anybody else who's reading or taking AP Lang, they will all read all of these. So this is one that as AP Lang people and Mr. Ruggles will reference all of these in AP Lit. So this is number one, so just put a one on it. Two will be Jonathan Kohler, The Closeness of Close Reading. Three, The Nature of Proof and the Interpretation of Poetry. Higher education. Going back to classroom, the close read section in your classroom, there were a couple Little concepts that I did not print off because they aren't articles, they are direction. So the first one was close reading, but what am I looking for? How do I read? And you see that rhetorical triangle again. You see the informational text triangle on there. It talks about the rhetorical situation, author, speaker, intention, content. Gives you questions to think about. So these are also questions you could use in your journal. If the questions I've provided you, you're like, nah, I don't want to use those. You know that there are a couple staple ones that you could do. The first four are pretty good for every single thing that you look at. But these are also questions that you could look at. I always say informational text, first thing you do is read it and soapstone it or smell it. We haven't talked about smell yet. We will. We haven't talked about smell, but soapstone it for sure. And you just write it out. And a lot of times I'll say to you, prove it. So you might want to put paragraph or a sentence in there so you know. Okay, so that was the informational article for informational text. If you haven't read that one, that's that first one up here. The other one that I thought was pretty good was a one of the like slides, PDFs, whatever, that I borrowed from one of the mentors that I went to the AP Lang class with, that he's just recycled from many years ago from Harvard. So talks about what is close reading, how do you do it. Step one, step two. If you didn't know some of these words, you might, you know, need to look those up. There comes that syntax, rhetorical strategies again. Semantic patterns, cognitive thinking, structural, analytical, arrange, linear. If you don't know those words, look them up, I guess. Best thing to do. And then step three is the most, pretty important, obviously. And then that was it. So it divides it not only into what it is, gives you questions on how to make sure that you're doing it, and then it gives you step-by-step instruction, knowing that you're not going to do all of those things. You don't have time in your life to do all of them. You're going to have to pick and choose which ones to do, and you're going to have to hope. And this is where the class started working together, and they said, when we do informational text, I'm always going to do question number four. I'm going to do other questions too, but I'm always going to do question number four. And everybody had a question that they would do, and like from this slide or from that packet or from this packet, they all had one that they were like a resident expert over, just like for the Kahoot, the rhetorical devices. And so they were sure that somebody was going to do that question when we had a Socratic seminar. So they would get it. And sooner or later, they all realized we're going to do them all because we don't trust everybody to do what they're supposed to do or not get it done. But at the beginning, they were, and that's how they built that whole community. Okay, that's how they built the, we're in this together. We're all trying to learn. We're looking for aha moments. Somebody do these questions. We can't do them all. Here we go. And so that's on you. I will not set it up. There was one person who always set that all up, had spreadsheets, did whatever, and they talked to each other. That's completely on you, okay? But I'm just giving you suggestions that it's been done. That's where they came up with their AP Twitter and their AP Snapchats, and they play games to get ready for the SAT because there's an app on your phone that you can do that, which I'll show you later. But that's, they became a little community. They were one for all and all for one kind of stuff, okay? Now, what I want to do, I want to first, I want to get to these readings, and I want to give you time to get to these readings in class, okay, so that we can be ready for tomorrow. But I want to go back to the EAA, okay? So the EAA, I told you that you only needed to do chapter 6, and I said that it wouldn't be due until probably Tuesday, we wouldn't get to it. But I've had a couple people tell me that you have never read chapter 1. That information is new, and I've also had people tell me that the fallacies, you picked a fallacy and each person knew their fallacy, but you don't know all of those. So I would say it sounds like you need to make sure you look at chapter 1, make sure you look at chapter 5, and make sure you look at chapter 6. There isn't a test over it. That's not what we do yet with this book, but notice in the reading journal, I reference EAA. In the critical reading slides, we've referenced EAA. So So this book becomes a really important textbook for us to make sure we understand that everything's an argument. And as soon as I say that, people then say, then we can argue everything. That's not what that title means, is that you can argue everything. Everything's an argument. That's what we're looking, everything we look at in here is argumentative. That's what it means. All right? Except for our fiction, which is not argumentative, that's fiction. So far, so good, get it? Okay, so I don't know, do I need to change that to say 1, 5, and 6 so you know which ones to read? Yes, no, or you know? I don't know. No, you're good? People are looking at me like, we get it, 1, 5, and 6. And if you don't know Etho, Pathos, Logos, then you read those and you're like, wow, those are some good examples, then great, because that's SAT. Friends, that's totally SAT. Okay, so looking at classroom, we've talked about the reading journals. We've done a little bit of curating, synthesizing, and reflecting and modeling what they're supposed to look like. What I want you to do right now is to look at somebody in your at your table. So you have 4 people at your table, then you have 4 people, divide 2 and 2. If you have 3, just work in a 3. But I want you to see someone else's notes. I just want you to see how they set it up so you can look at it. So all you do is stand up. It's just a little gallery. Go ahead and stand up. Take a little stretch. Look at your other person's notes. So just switch spots. Or if you're in a group of 3, get together and say, let's look at each person's notes because, wow, you might have something cool. Okay, 5 minutes. Look and have a little conversation on somebody else's good stuff that you see there.
Talking about the mockingbird or the one that is back.
And then her is back.
Okay. And then I have a little bit of the
thing.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
When you're done, just find your way back to your seat. When you're done, find your way back to your seat.
Okay, so did you get that baseball statistics homework done?
Yeah.
Who was the better one?
Well, I didn't make a claim about that. What's that?
You can't tell me if you're pushing.
Dude, I got 2 hours after this.
Well, just an FYI, I'm pretty sure it's Mark McGuire.
I'll pull it up.
Alright, did you notice anything? Anyone notice anything different? Anybody notice a different way of doing it that you're like, oh, I like how that person did that, or I like that thought? Yeah.
I kind of created a system where initially I wrote on both the right and left sides, but I made it clear that the left side, what I initially wrote on the left side was not a reflection, it was notes of what to put on the left side, and what to put on the right side, and then I made it clear once we did those reflective notes for like 5 minutes or whatever afterwards, those were reflective notes. Wyatt simply just wrote down what he needs on each side in a long list.
Okay.
And apparently that's what seems to be best for him.
Okay, so bullets could work, long list could work, okay, what else did you note? Yeah.
Shouldn't you use sticky notes, like, over what she already wrote to reflect?
Okay, cool. Anybody else notice something? How many people are doing handwritten notes? I'm using a paper and pencil, okay? How many people are using computer or Chromebooks?
I'm going to use a notebook, but today I did it on
Chromebook. I will tell you that I do know that one of the people who didn't get a good score on their free response was because of illegibility. They couldn't read their handwriting.
Okay, this is all in print, and if you can't read it, then you can leave.
So I'm telling you, they won't struggle to read it. So because we don't use pencils very often, or pens, and it's blue or black ink for the free response, our penmanship slides down. And because we're texters and social media people and all that. So sometimes I don't have a preference. You do what you need to do to be successful. Mr. Miller will show you, you know, places to put notes also, so it's all together. One thing I do recommend is that if you're using any type of electronic, so if you're using your Chromebooks, start in a folder. So immediately name the folder AP, and I would put journal responses or journal reading, so that you know that this is where your journal readings are at, so that it's not just a document hanging out anywhere. Always start folders, and I can show you how to do that if you don't know how to do that. Okay? Next thing. Okay, so here's where I want to ask you, which way do you want to go? Okay? We have our rhetorical, our introduction to rhetoric, and you had four speeches that you were supposed to read, and you were supposed to soapstone them, right? Okay, reflect and soapstone. Do we wanna start there, or do you want some time, and you're not gonna read all of these again, you're just gonna read two and then two the next day? Actually, I think I'll just have you read one and make sure you're doing it right. Do you want, or do you want to start here? Where do you wanna go? Do you wanna do soapstone the four speeches and talk about that? And take a break from close reading, and know you'll have to do this one packet for, it's not really a packet, it's just read it and do your journal response for it. Which one do you want? So how many people would like to go back to this with our four informational text speeches and soapstone it? No? Two, three, we have to share it out sometime. Four, five, six, seven. There's 17 people, so there's 10, there's two people gone, so let's do this. Let's go, let's just do it. So open up, yep.
Are you gonna want?
I'll get them at the end, so people turn them in on Friday. Okay, so let's do this. I'm gonna give each table a speech. Okay, I'm gonna give you each one of the speeches, and you're going to be the expert group on that speech. So far, so good? Okay, so I'm going to give your table, I'll give you guys Lou Gehrig, okay? You guys will have Martin Luther King. You guys will have Steve Jobs. And you guys will have Tom Hanks. Now, what does it mean if you're the resident expert? All you're going to do is when I say, okay, because you're supposed to do this for homework, so I'm going to say to you, soapstone it. But before you can soapstone it with the class, you have to talk with your group to make sure you're all on the same page. So have a conversation with the people in your group and make sure that your soapstone matches up. Try to give us a cool new tone word. The definition of it, show us in the text. If you say something is tone, you better be able to tell us what paragraph, you better be able to tell us what sentence, so that you can prove informational text-wise that it works. Same thing with all the soapstone. If you say it's an occasion is this, you better make sure that you can prove it. So move however you have to move to be with the people in your group. Talk to them. You don't have to marry them, kiss them, or hold their hands. You simply have to have a conversation with them and figure out that your soapstone is right. I'm gonna give you 10 minutes. Hopefully we'll share out in 5, and then you'll have a half hour to get started on your close reading. Go ahead and do that.
Okay, so for the speaker, I'm looking here. That's really now. Okay. And then the audience, I have my friends, the audience, like people. That's the audience. I think the occasion is obviously the Civil War, the march on
Washington.
Yeah. And, where he's dressing.
What do you find?
for the.
Wait, what?
I put for the purpose down here is to begin the end of racism in the U.S.
I call for racism, you call for an end to racism.
Yes. And then for tone, I use very determined, dignified, and with precise intent.
I said hopeful.
Yeah. Like my topic.
I just realized I wrote that down.
Okay, you want for the tone, I should be writing.
Oh, dang, you got me.
I know, right?
What'd you put?
But,
I said, and.
Yeah.
We already moved on to the cat back there. Okay, so brain's a passion, what's that say?
Impassion.
Three phrases, very dignified.
I got.
Well, very determined, dignified, and with precise intent. Now, who's going to share?
I got hopeful because I had a dream and that one day, so it's looking forward to the future.
We should make brain talk. Definitely. You are really want to hear me speak to them.
We do every day.
Yeah.
Yeah,
but I mean, you contributed those to the group discussion.
Okay, I'll do it.
So,
it's hard not to.
Basically, I know it down to the he connects in turn to the American people by saying, like, let freedom ring. And, like, that kind of connects to the American vision of, like, freedom and being your own country. And he also humanizes himself by humidifiers himself by talking about like his children, and so it makes him really like, relatable, and that adds credibility to his speech, and so like it makes it feel more emotional because you realize he's a real person, and it makes you want to like.
I thought that was. I was just about to say, you know, not like fish egg or like all that. I was like, okay, that last phrase saved you.
I'll use the one where.
But how does that contribute to self tone? Is that just the tone itself, or is that his credibility as a speaker as well?
It makes it like part of the speaker's
reflection.
Well, yeah, but it also like adds to the speaker part of it because like. Rather than just saying Martin Luther King Jr., like, the speaker is somebody who's had to deal with this firsthand and, like, actually has experience in trying to get it to end because he's unhappy with the situation in the area that he's at.
I didn't really go to that extent. I didn't know, like, he was an activist.
That's when he took the calligraphy class.
Oh, yeah.
So I just did it fast.
But if you, like, are thinking about from the time the speech is given, then you can, like, if you went up before Martin Luther King Jr. gave a speech, and he's like, yeah, Martin Luther King Jr. said that, he's the person who said that, the person would be like, because I totally know who he is. So, but if you were to say, is somebody who's actually dealt with this firsthand, their children have gone through, and they have experienced racism for things.
I get what you're saying.
Yeah, so like, I guess that's just
like
basically,
my question.
Don't know
my question is,
yeah.
So, how does that contribute to Soapstone? But, like, how does that contribute to it? I'd say,
well, each element of Soapstone has its sub element within
it. It contributes to the speaker. Because, like, the speaker isn't just Martin Luther King Jr., it's somebody who's witnessed it.
He's using ethos appeals to
Well, ethos would be if he was well known. Ethos is more like you're a well known person. No, at the time, Brandon's saying that he wasn't as well known as he was now.
He was fairly at the time.
I wouldn't know. You need pathos to establish emotion for people to be able to relate to. Why are we talking about this? We got sidetracked.
I think what you were saying is more towards purpose.
I don't know where I'm like trying to be.
That's good.
And even Nancy likes helps.
Can't bring anybody
like
this. I'll say it, like, sure. Like, speak to Martin Luther King. Yes,
Martin Luther King.
Yeah, Martin. If I talk today, I'm gonna die.
You hashtag can't even.
You hashtag can't even.
I'm not gonna call
JRM.
So, on that last paragraph,
what did you put for
civil rights?
Civil rights.
So, when I was talking
I kind of, where did I put this?
That's how I said it.
I did not put this. The subject I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and look out for me, and it's really be self-evident that all men are created equal.
Quality.
Well, it's my whole
I said to give in.
I love this word.
I'm like, he speaks for
me.
What are we saying?
We've got to use something better than, like, on a four-year-old.
I think we're, like, successful.
And we shouldn't say more than one phrase. Okay, so what did you have for tone again?
Impassion.
Tech support, find it.
Maybe she said something about children somewhere, and I want to figure out where he said
that. It's like right in the beginning, dude. I have a dream that one day my four children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of skin, but by the strength of character. He's looking for that section.
You have about 3 more minutes in your crew.
He's like really passionate.
That's what E stands for?
I want to see if I can find him.
Dignified is a word.
Well, I wouldn't say dignified because that's more like a form of speech, but he's trying to make himself seem more.
But with precise, like maybe with precise intent, or like something about passion, and with precise intent, because he's doing, he's trying to accomplish his one goal. It's like emotional.
I like the
whole
optimistic.
Emotionally, emotionally derived.
Because the whole point of it is looking to be like one day this will happen.
Emotionally driven.
I underline
that. That
be
a good
are you looking for a phrase?
Wait.
Yes, for Tom. Emotionally driven.
Yeah, I think that's your picture.
Got
it.
That whole
paragraph.
It's
me.
Determined and passionate.
God,
this is like it spoke to my life.
You're maybe.
Say happy.
Say happy. That one's probably off. But I take when I got a little bit strong. I can do poems. Okay.
I like passion.
How many parts?
I feel like passion is kind of like an all-around kind of thing. Like anybody can be passionate if you're
But like this person is.
That's a fact of all. You know, you're going 90 degrees and do like.
I can't wait till I'm 90 years old. How was it when you're like 1 year?
He's not going to remember anything we planned anyway. He's going to go straight out of his brain. He's not hearing anything I'm saying.
But I'd honestly just say passionate in terms of like, that's the most overwhelming thing I get from this.
Okay, now what do you have down on the subject? And it doesn't look like you have it.
For the subject, I put purpose instead of subject.
Subject and purpose are two different
things. You need to submit the subject.
There's subject and purpose. Subject goes first.
Well, subject is right.
Yes, purpose is to end it.
Like,
or to begin the end.
Apple.
Subtract racism, add dude, you got sideburns and you got
ripped. I know, I went to get my hair cut, and I walked out there and I'm like,
so just let it grow and like get one of those.
No, I'm gonna get it like trimmed before school. After I see Elvis,
get one of those
Well, is, are we, he hits the audience as the American people, are we going to say the American people or the
people? Wasn't it like fraud cast on a,
it was,
he,
okay.
Was,
but it was,
but
no,
his
it was directed,
directed
at the civil rights.
Civil rights person.
Doesn't he say like all across America? Like, I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, a desert, sold for sale.
Fair enough.
The heat of the desert and oppression.
Did he even know he was going
to
be on?
I don't know. Was it talking to the cameras, talking to the people?
I think it's talking about the entire nation,
we also
so it's relevant to all.
Please try to wrap it up and then head back to your seat.
I think it's all.
Just say bold. Say but
it had the extended. But it had the extended.
Well, why don't you talk? You can both talk, Emily. Okay, right, well then you can talk, because I'm gonna say what I want to say.
No, it's speaker subject. It's speaker subject. You said subject.
I have those mixed up.
Well, can't tell you how it's going to go.
You go speaker.
Are you ready for those? Yeah. Everybody ready?
Not the word.
Oh, my God. I don't know. Okay. 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 Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Being recorded when he gave the speech.
No, we knew.
Can we like
you know how hard it is?
the extent of where it would go. You know, like I think he just thought maybe, because he was a public figure, but I don't think he thought it was going to be heard. He was hoping it would be heard everywhere, but I would think he knew it was going to be recorded.
Nope, sounds like I'm right.
Because in that year they had TV, you know, you could go historically outside and find outside tax information. Even though you can't do that in the heat test, you could for the sake of discussion.
Still say a thing about the 200.
Okay, I'm gonna stop you.
But it extends.
Okay. I think I wanna save your resident expert until tomorrow. I want to make sure you're on the same page with everybody in your group. If you're not, I hope you battle it out. Because what I'm going to do tomorrow is number you off. And you, within your group, I'm going to number you off. And you're going to be the resident expert for another group. So, for example, if you're Martin Luther King, you're probably going to be the only person in that group talking about Martin Luther King. So you need to be accurate. So everyone needs to make sure they know what they're talking about in their little groups. The group of four, one person will be in, you know, you guys will have two in one group and whatever. And then I don't know what to do with these boys over here. Put them in and let them just listen, maybe. Or I could say, they need to, I'll do this. Grant needs to soapstone, what was your group? Jobs?
No, Tom Hanks.
Tom Hanks. Grant, you need to soapstone Tom Hanks. And Arden, you need to soapstone, what was your group?
Lou Gehrig.
There, I assigned it to him, so they'll have it on. We'll test them to see if they actually watch the video, so no one tell them. Okay? we'll test them, no one tell them.
That'll
be a true test.
That's great, too, because Grant needed that Tom Hanks. He despised.
Did he? Ooh. Okay, are you good? You know who your people are, and you'll be, if you're okay when I number you off and I go, you're a four to Grant, and he's like, what? I'm a four for what? Well, no. Well, I'll go, they didn't do what they were supposed to do. Which, they're human. It's okay. Now, I'm not trying to tell you to get them. If you're feeling bad right now, like, oh, we're trying to set them up for failure, they'll be okay. I'll give them a couple minutes to talk to you before we break into groups again, okay? Mm-hmm. So you guys can catch them up. Got it? Okay, now, here's what I want to do. We're not done with this packet. There are some words in here, like the very first one, that maybe in the chart you might not know how to pronounce it or what it is. I heard some discussion of ethos, pathos, and logos in here. So we're going to do the assignment in here, but we're going to do it in class tomorrow once we've shared all of our soapstones. Got it? Okay. What do you need to do between now and the next time we lay eyes upon each other? I put it on here so you could see it. I put today's Monday. We discussed and introduced the reading journal. We shared our soapstone for the introduction to the rhetoric, and we did that in groups. We have homework, EAA chapters 1, if you haven't read it and you don't know what it is, 5, if you don't know the fallacies, and concentrating heavily on 6, knowing that you are responsible for 1 through 6. And then homework, the close reading article number 1. What makes a good reader and what makes good writers? And then there are some questions to consider. So I've given you 11 questions to consider that would probably be a good home for the answers in your journal, your reading journals, as you're reading this. So this we will get to tomorrow, and this for sure. You've probably maybe already read some of these, whatever, and you're just rereading. That's what you're doing. Got it? Okay, so the time is yours to work on what you need to work on to be successful tomorrow. I will tell you, imagine this, just think for a second. You will only have 42 minutes with me every day. That is a blink of an eye. You've been lucky enough to have 2 hours or unlucky enough to have 2 hours with me to digest all of this. So imagine when you only have 42 minutes, how fast it's going to go, okay? It doesn't get less because we still have to accomplish the same amount,
But what we've done is you are already in AP. You are on day 5 and 6 today because you've been here 3 days. So you are already in AP. You've survived 6 days of AP because we've had 2 hours each day. So far, so good. And I haven't had any tears. Has anyone cried yet?
No.
Oh, you came close once.
What?
You came close once.
Well, I will always cry when I talk about my mom or I talk about something emotional. I will. I always will. But 6 days, I will tell you, day three, I had people crying. Day three, I had people crying last year. The year before, day two, I had people crying in tears. And I really haven't done a whole bunch, but I think the difference is you've had 2 hours. You've had 2 hours every day to reflect and think and get a grasp. They had to like, I mean, it was boom, boom, boom. So here's what I want to tell you. When I say you have 25 minutes, you have 25 minutes to decide what are you going to do? You're going to do this? You're going to read this? Are you going to go EAA? Or are you going to start looking to Till Mockingbird and get that reorganized? Because you see, we're going to read that again and do our journals right, correctly. Okay? So maybe you're not going to read it all over again. It's not due until September or something. Maybe you're not going to reread it. But you better take some better notes. And I know the difference when you Google notes, because some people were Googling stuff. You are 17 years old. When you start talking like you're 25, 30, and 35, like analysis people, when you've gone to Cliff Notes or Schmoop or whatever you go to, I know the difference. I'm old. I've seen it all. So don't do it that way. That's not what I'm expecting you to do. I don't expect that from you. You're 17. You've read it for the first time. You shouldn't sound like you've read it 26 times like me. You can still look at those things. Go for it. But I don't expect you to know some of those things because there's no way the first time you read it, you'll see it. Okay, I shut up. You decide. I will dismiss you at 10 o'clock. Yes, dear.
Did you say you have certain questions for us for the close reading article?
It's this.
Are they in there?
They're right here on the front.
Oh, right.
They're right on the front. Yeah.
You want these right in the column?
Yes, please. Notes from here on out are in our reading journal. Our reading journal from here on out. Yes, dear. Yes, there's free hole punch up here. You can free hole punch anything you want. All I ask is that you are quiet so that those people who want to get started can use the time wisely. And I'm going to read again, too. Last thing, what are the clouds for and the lightning bolts? Your aha moment today. What are some aha moments that you got today in class? That's your exit slip out, so you might want to do that first and then get busy. Just a couple, 2, 3 aha moments from today.
Do you want our names on?
I don't need your name on.
Can I help you?
I'll put mine on the back.
There's a black one that's better. There's a black one that's thicker and better. Yeah, you can use this.
Oh, Maya, these notes are legible.
I know.
I'm just like addressing the whole table.
No, he goes.
These notes are legible, Caitlin.
All right, I was just saying.
I just assumed that was mine until you're proofing off. Sorry, Maya.
Can you help? Let me help.
It's better if you put it like down on the
this
table.
Is gonna be a
hold on to that baby.
This is gonna
it
be a
may be
long
too
day.
Thick,
go
and you may
here.
Have to tear it up, take this table out.
It will
be a long year if y'all don't proof.
Want me along here if you don't bring ibuprofen.
It's hard.
You see.
Okay,
no, it can be any, you've been 6 days in here. Any aha moment that you have. that go there again.
He said, I rolled my eyes.
What?
So you have to put in a paycheck?
Myth legend, you know how it all goes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Are these extras because I'm missing?
And then you go and text.